The second day from the 25th European Artistic Gymnastics Championships in Patras, Greece. Last weekend was the women, this weekend is the men. If you were unable to join Eurosport's coverage yesterday, you missed a cracking team competition where Romania came out on top. From those results, the top 24 qualify for competition two, the men's all-around. We join the action after three apparatus at the halfway point with Revelnich of Latvia leading, Yovchev of Bulgaria second, Cano of Spain third. The top qualifier, Potra of Romania, in fourth position after a disastrous opening round. Then the favourites from Russia, Podgorini and Bondarenko, just behind in fifth and sixth position. And as you can see, Kanukai Jackson from the British team. Pretty good start so far in 11th place. Three pieces of apparatus to go. Of course, each and every one of the competitors picking up a score on all six pieces and all the scores added together. And it's quite a simple calculation. The highest will take top position. Well, as always, joining myself, Nick Fellows, in the commentary box, Eurosport's resident gymnast expert, Monica Phelps, on loan from the Olga Gym in Poole in Dorset. An interesting start, Monica. We're going to watch Felipe Bazugo with his pommel horse for Portugal, but quite a shock to see Potra from Romania look very nervous and really have quite a disaster in his first piece.
Yes, well, he has everything to lose and is nervous, and Revelnich had nothing to lose coming in eighth place. So, but there are six disciplines to go. And this, the fourth rotation, and the Portuguese Bazugo coming in this top 24 in 20th position. But doing very well to qualify for the top 24 gymnasts, but coming to grief, really not built as a pommel horse worker. The short guys don't find it very easy. The longer-legged guys have much more inertia to make this piece of apparatus easier for them, but just not managing to keep his center of gravity above the handles, the pommels. He's got 30 seconds in which to continue his exercise. The maximum marks are 10, but not all gymnasts manage to get the 1.2 bonus points set aside. So we can hopefully say that most of these gymnasts will be marked out of a minimum of 8.8.
Well, not to be expected to be challenging for the top positions. Here's the trouble of the Portuguese number one once again. Puerto Rican number one, I should say. My apologies to all the Portuguese fans tuning in. Now let's take a look at one of the competitors very much in the chase, representing Russia from Siberia, of all places. This is Evgeny Podgorini, qualifying in fourth position. He's in that top group, which really does have the big guns. Potra of Romania, Podgorini, of course, now on the vault. Bondarenko and Roman Zazulia of Ukraine looking to maintain their impressive performances with the absence of the defending champion, Alexandra Beresh.
And he's demonstrating that he's going to do a handspring. And it's a handspring double, which is a 9.8 start value. But really, he is a victim of sitting down on the floor and probably out of the medals on that. They only have one shot at vault in this in competition two. Coming in over-rotated, under-rotated, feet in front of the hips and bouncing back down and losing himself 5/10.
Well, this is the surprise so far of this men's all-around European Championship competition. Never before have Latvia won a men's European medal, never mind a gold. And as we can see, this is Erik Revelnich, who is leading and has been looking very strong. Bondarenko took the lead after the first round, but through rotations two and three, the Latvian has looked very competent and very strong indeed. This is fourth of six performances, and the lead so far looking pretty impressive.
And a very elegant gymnast indeed. Long lines, good stretched legs and good extension through the shoulders. Lovely long moy. Straddling from the swing, quarter turn, little crisis there. Oh, and in that Arabian quarter, over twisting, getting some side arch. Short exercise, not fulfilling the full criteria of bonus points, but execution wise he'll gain. There are two panels of judges, two juries, an A jury who define the start value and a B jury who deal with the execution. And of course, he'll be favored by the B jury on that exercise, not so much the A jury.
Well, the 22-year-old from Riga, the Latvian capital, seventh in the European Championships in Paris back in 1998, but only 20th in Bremen 2 years ago, and he really is on form for a massive improvement. He'll fly up the European rankings, and he just needs to hold on here. One possibly senses that he's now just going for consistency rather than something fancy. He really has done exceptionally well going into the halfway point. The Puerto Rican Bazugo taking a 39.399 point score now after four rotations, but you can see all in the eights, and we're looking for a competitor for all in the nines. This is going to be a tough score for Podgorini. As Monica has pointed out, a tumble such as that, when each and every score is absolutely vital, at 8.975 for the vault of the Russian number two, puts him down in second position, but he will be unlikely to claw back from that position unless there are big mistakes from others. Still holding on to the lead, Revelish from Latvia, 36.961, 8.675, his lowest score so far. But again, that good start still keeps the Latvian in top position. Now, let's take a look at the Romanian. Of course, Romania, for the first time ever, taking the team gold here yesterday, reversing the result of 2 years ago, getting the better of Russia. Now, Dan Potra, the top qualifier, so possibly putting himself under a fair bit of pressure before the start. That pressure clearly shown in his first performance on the floor, where he stepped out of the floor to pick up those penalty marks. But he's slowly but surely clawing his way back. So, Monica, starting off as the big hot favourite, but now he finds himself on the comeback trail.
Well, I think we just have to look at the history of Romania in both men and women, and they are really, really tough competitors. So I think that we can guarantee he'll put in 100% effort. It may not be 100% success.
Well, I think the director, Monica, has nipped across, and understandably so. This is Maras, the young Greek 19-year-old from Athens. He's going to perform his high bar apparatus. He's the world champion in high bar. So you can see we're cutting between one and the other, because we want to see the Romanian Petra, but we want to see also young Maras, who I know has caught your eye as we were watching some of the earlier rounds before we came to our broadcast today. So hopefully we can squeeze in both. 354 is a Romanian, already claiming one gold. And there you see the young 19-year-old, and he really does look a slight youngster, a bronze medalist from the European Juniors of 2 years ago in Bremen. And then making his senior mark by taking the World High Bar Gold in Ghent last year. Here's the one and only vault for the Romanian, Dan Petra.
And looking at, there's a little illuminated board at the back which tells us which group this is from, the Sukahara group, and he's performed that with two twists, coming in very under rotated and quite a low vault. So I think a little bit of a wry smile, thank goodness I'm on my feet kind of thing, but not a brilliant vault. Have a look in slow motion. He certainly is gathering enough speed, coming on with the half twist entry, and then one and a half somersaults, two twists. But can you see just how short he was? He really did hammer his ankles, didn't quite get his feet together throughout the flight. But a 9.7 start value, so it's big stuff. And remember, six disciplines, so they really have to go to cope well. And 9.337 is scored on that, so he'll be delighted. And that's taken him up into first spot.
And he goes into the lead for the first time. Now watch this young man, this youngster, in our minds, in only his second year of senior competition, has a massive future ahead of him. He does look a youngster as well. Definitely this is the host nation to the 2004 Summer Games main hope for a medal in artistic gymnastics. Of course, this is the Greek number one, Valosis Maras.
And he is a startling talent, aesthetically. He's compact, powerful, and just look at how he copes with that Gaylord with the half twist. Kicks out from it. Lovely stoop through into the full turn and E element. One of the most difficult. So he really has mastered the big stuff as well as the quality of execution. And that was superb. Only 19 years old, and The home crowd really enthusiastic about this talent, and he really is a massive talent. I really do think that he'll be in the medals in Athens if he keeps this standard going.
Well, we look forward to seeing Maras live on Eurosport in the high bar finals, individual apparatus finals, that is, of course, tomorrow.
And just look at this, two somersaults with a half twist, and he extends right out of the half twist. Mitch Gaylord, the American, the innovator of that skill, back in the LA Olympics in 84, and Maras having mastered it to fine form. There, the full turning giant on one arm. And then he winds up in fine style. Just watch the block of his feet into this dismount. He stops his feet there and then twists. Two twists, two somersaults, and a wee jump forward on the landing.
What a good performance from Maras. And the home crowd really give him something to cheer for, because he's been pulling his way up the standings after a bit of a slow start. And there you see, going into fourth position at the halfway point in rotation four. And a good score, a massive score, a 9700. We'll take a quick break, but we'll be back with the Russian favourites after these messages.
Afternoon.
Welcome back to Patras. Rotation four of six in the men's all-around competition. Roman Zazulia for the Ukraine. Fourth in the last European Championships in this competition and the second best qualifier. And of course, the Ukraine, coached by Igor Korobchinsky, himself an all-round European champion in 89 and 92.
Oh, and big vault and brilliant landing. Brilliant handspring. Two and a half front somersault. Of course, the other half comes because he's coming from his hands. And absolutely brilliantly performed. Hitting the front of the apparatus, extending through the shoulders, closed the hips a fraction early, and not as tidy in the air with his feet as some of the gymnasts, but spotted the landing really, really well. A 9.8 start value on that vault. We've only seen 1.10 start value in this competition. That was from Dragulescu, and he did that very same vault with a half twist.
Well, we'll get back to the scores then. That will be a big score. Now this is Kwiatkowski, Sven Kwiatkowski of Germany, and again Kwiatkowski is in with a shout. Monica lying in seventh position, again one of the starters that didn't seem to be affected. No pressure upon the Germans' shoulders coming into this competition, qualifying in sixth position. This could be an outside chance for the German team.
Well, the Germans proving that they have got strength and depth, of course, medalling in the junior event and coming fifth in the men's team. So on an individual basis, he might be making a few errors, but they're really proving as a nation that they're back on the scene and fighting towards the future world and Olympic titles. The last big German name was Eberhard Ginger, and we mention his name often in his innovative skill on high bar, but Kwiatkowski finishing in style, but a couple of mini crises in the middle, and obviously a bit of a sore bicep there. And what a place to have a sore bicep on P-bars, where you so often have to land on the rails on them, like here. Coming in there, oh, can almost feel the pain. Asymmetric on the landing, obviously trying to avoid that injured bicep. Coming in on the one rail, oh, lacking terribly in flexibility there and struggling in that straddle up. So he hasn't been doing his homework. And again, having to split his legs on the dismount because his hamstrings are too tight. And of course, lacking in flexibility makes one more prone to injury.
Well, that makes a big difference to Zazulia's standing. 9.587 for his vault, rocketing from ninth to fourth position. That's a good performance. Now let's stay with the vault. Of course, the top four qualifiers in this group or on this apparatus right now. Alexei Bondarenko next to go, the 1998 European all-around champion, the 24-year-old originally from Kazakhstan, now residing in Moscow, third top qualifier prior to this all-around event.
It's interesting to note his good coordination in the air When we see that in slow motion, even though we saw Zazulia get a fabulous score, 9-5 plus, we saw a booty split tuck. But you see that Bondarenko's coordination a little bit finer, even has his feet stretched in the tucked somersault. See how nimble he appears in the air. Just a fraction short, though, and having to step back. So the stretched toes in the somersault will count for a great deal, unfortunately.
Well, Bondarenko lies in sixth position. Monica, you've often said that he's one of the most stylish out there. Kwiatkowski for Germany goes into sixth position. 36.212 with two apparatus or two more scores to be picked up. The German will be happy. Now, this is another man that's very much in the chase. And if you look at the form from the World Championships last year, where Feng, of course, of China took top position, Ivankov, who's absent today, took the silver. Yovchev, now on screen from Bulgaria, took the bronze. And Petra of Romania was fourth. And those were the two tipped to be battling it out. Both got off to a slightly slow start, but both have their more favoured apparatus in the last two rounds of the competition. Now, Yovchev, a very experienced gymnast now, Monica, 29 years of age, living and working over in the USA when out of international competition.
Yes, he's in Oklahoma now, but returns to Bulgaria to train with the Bulgarian team, but a fantastic gymnast, and I think the whole world of gymnastics would like to see him major. Never won a major title. And he's been so near. Sydney so near, and Ghent so near. And once again, he's just knocking on the door of the gold. Great gymnast, fine finish there. Some nimble stuff. His double front was just a little bit low there on P-bars, but very neat stuff. He's a little pocket Hercules, tiny man, standing just over 5 feet tall. Just look at the musculature on his upper body. Striated deltoids, just showing the strain. Tremendous upper body power. And there the double tuck, but a bit low and really coming in very heavily on his upper arms. And he'll get a penalty for that, of course. But he goes on to spot a brilliant dismount. And not many manage to do this on this double pike. Anchoring his slight arch very well, flying back. It's a somersault from hands to hands. Looks so easy, but just look at this landing. No, he's not going to show us this landing. We're going to see that double back for the third time. But we all hope for Yovchev. He's a brilliant floor worker, brilliant ring worker. If anything, an Achilles heel is his pommel horse work. But yes, there is the landing that we were looking for.
And let's take a look at the score. Goes into second position, and that is another good performance. 9.187 for the P-bars for Jordan Yovchev of Bulgaria. Very much in the chase. Bondarenko, 37. Whoa, that is so close. It's 37.112. So, although Bondarenko has gone into top position, look at that. 112 to 111 between Russia and Bulgaria. Petra, the Romanian top qualifier, now third. Early leader, Revelinch of Latvia, is in fourth. Podgorny, 5. Zazulia, 6. Maras of Greece, 7. And Kwiatkowski of Germany in eighth position. Well, looking for Kanukai Jackson of Britain, 12th position. Still a respectable performance from the British number one, our sole contender in this men's all-around competition. A very, very close event. And in the last two apparatus, well, it'll go right to the wire for the European all-around title of 2002. We move on to apparatus and rotation 5 of 6. And, of course, we'll take a quick break. But we'll be back with the closing stages of this men's all-around after these short messages. Don't go away. European Championships of Artistic Gymnastics here on Eurosport. It's the men's all-around competition, Competition 2 as it's known. Vlasios Maras, very impressive high bar performance. The best score so far of these championships are 9-7. Now, this is the young Greek performer's floor exercise. Very well, lying in seventh position. If he can keep going at the rate that he is, could get into the top five.
Yeah, what a fabulous ranking for a 19-year-old. I mean, bearing in mind that not only he can execute fantastic work, but he can deliver it under pressure. And there are a lot of gymnasts out there who can train it in the gym, but not many who can come to a major event and deliver it in front of the judges and the audience. And even though it's great for him to be on home territory, it's a tremendous pressure. Because great expectations from him, and he better get used to it because he's got Athens 2004 to cope with. And working wisely on floor. Yeah, he's obviously a smart gymnast and has a smart coach. Not working too hard on the double back somersaults at 19. He's not quite fully grown. Ankle joints and wrist joints still suspect, under pressure and high impact. So it's far better to work on single somersaulting. But he's certainly got no problem with orientation. Three forward rotating skills, finishing off with a full twist. The whip back, 1.5 twisting back somersault into the Rudy, which is a 1.5 twisting front somersault. But again, you see, no double somersaults. And this is very smart coaching with a boy of this talent. He's obviously going to hit the headlines, so he's not hammering his ankles on tumbling. And finishing with a double twist, so a clean exercise. It's not going to score in the high nines, if in the nines at all. But consistency is the name of the game when you're in an all-around event.
Well, he goes into first position because that's the first score to go into the computer in this, the fifth rotation, 45.512. But Maras, well, a massive talent for the future. And as Monica quite rightly pointed out, Greece hosting the 2004 Olympic Games. And at 21 years of age, I'm sure that young man will be popping doubles on the floor with relative ease. Okay, let's go over now to the men's parallel bars. This is Dan Potra. Again for Romania, very important to watch this performance because after four rotations, Petra is now in third position, top qualifier, remember.
And he's looking extremely assertive, struggled a little bit on that top change. And I think his routine, pardon my criticism, for somebody who's likely to become a European champion or is in the lead, but it does lack amplitude. Some of the skills rather small, not traveling along the parallel rails or above the parallel rails to any great degree. But with significant control, very difficult to work out of and then into the straddle cut. So great deal of ballistic flexibility required to get those legs around the rails. Nice straight arm lift to the handstand. And showing superb control from that handstand into the dismount. Not superb control on the landing though. But he's looking for good average nines there. Another one, 9.262. So other than that start on floor in the eights, he's just built gradually back up to the lead. So we are looking at a potential medalist for sure.
Well, he still holds on to the third position, goes into first, and the first of the parallel bar exercises. This is Campos next to go for Portugal.
Nice combination there. Three front rotating skills, finishing with a 1.75 front somersault. Whip back, 1.5 twist. Backwards into 1.5 twist forward, be it a little under rotated. But he stayed well inside the floor area, but very nimble. gymnastics is all about the speed of muscular reaction, and the more high fast twitch fiber they have within their body, the better equipped they are to produce high level gymnastics. And a very powerful little guy. Men have to show as much versatility in tumbling forwards, backwards, and sideways, finishing there with a 2.5 twisting back somersault and rebounding immediately off the floor, which is called a punch action into the punch front. Here the straight front, full twisting, straight full twisting, puck into 1¾ forward roll.
Anders Pettersson for Sweden. Not really in the chase, but we're trying to show you as many of the nations that have qualified for this men's all-around competition, and good to see two Swedes in the top 24 after yesterday's competition one.
Yes, it's a long time since we've seen some Swedish influence in the top 24, not since Johan Jonasson, and back before that in the, I think, 60s, Kuhn and Lindeval. But great to see them back up there. Full twisting double, dismount on rings. Quite a good gymnast to produce that level skill, and two of them in the top 24. That's great for Swedish gymnastics. Not quite down to horizontal in that cross. Oh yes, it is a struggle, it hurts.
Now let's quickly get back. We're moving as quick as we can to try and bring you all of the top guns, although certainly vying for the medals. And this is Ukraine's main hope here today. Roman Zazulia, of course, the Ukraine, took the gold in the last Europeans, with Baresh not competing in the all-around this year. So Zazulia, the sole representative for the Ukraine in this competition too.
Very elegant young man, very elegant gymnast indeed. Reminds me of Nemov in his elegance. But he's got long levers, needs an enormous amount of back strength to deal. Nice shoulder roll there out of the double. Already having produced two double somersaults in the P-bars and then smashing double back pike dismount. So a very businesslike routine, executed with fine aesthetic lines. There's the backward double to forearms into the forward shoulder roll, press from forearms to handstand and immediately into the half turn. Nice little link into the double. So, high ranking skills there from Zazulia.
Sixth position after four rotations. It's a good performance from Zazulia. We'll take a look at Samaloglu from Turkey. Again, good to see the Turkish number one qualify for the top 24. Superb performance, and could be one of the lesser known nations to potentially take a medal in the individual apparatus finals tomorrow.
That would be nice to double up with the weightlifter, wouldn't it? Oh dear. Very nimble first series, but stepping out there and losing a tenth. But nice gymnast, very nice. 2.5 twist punch front into punch Barani. That's a front somersault with a half a turn. It's not an Indian meal. And there, an Arabian 1.5 twisting dive roll in a pucked position. We saw Yovchev do that in the straight position. And something that all the gymnasts must demonstrate. Pirouetting on the hands and show flexibility. It's a backward roll handstand with half a turn. Very fluent exercise. And a clean dismount there, double twist. And that's great to see Turkey represented in this top 24. And with a very neat exercise, I must say.
It's done Turkey proud that Ümit Zamaloglu. And some pretty impressive tumbling, but I agree, Monica, it just seemed to flow. It all seemed to go at the right tempo and at the right pace. That was the only problem for the Turkish number one. Immediately penalized for stepping out, but again, another youngster with a lot of promise.
Yes, and when we see routines like this, as a coach, I can see, so I'm willing to sort of exude the praise. You can see that it's a well-rehearsed routine. It's got its own special rhythm because he's been through it so many times.
Well, the current leader for Russia, Alexei Bondarenko, the Russians looking to turn the tables on Romania, who, of course, took the team competition here yesterday. Bondarenko, former European champion in 1998, now 24 years of age, qualified with the third best score yesterday, originally from Kazakhstan, now training with a Dynamo club out of Moscow.
And Bondarenko just out of the medals in 2000, and he's a hungry gymnast. He'll be looking to get into the medals and he'll be looking for gold. But a particular favorite of mine, I find him very pleasing to watch. He's smart, he's strong, lithe, very fit for his game. A lovely series of skills. Oh yes. And just a lot of practice those combinations will have taken. But the speed and fluency of the routine really delivered excellently. So the two panels of judges will be very, well, one panel very busy. The A panel deciding on the start value will be very busy. And I think the B panel will have hardly put pen to paper because their job is to take off execution marks and there aren't really that many. A little bit of slack legs there in the straddle cut, but a very nimble hop, half turn in the pike position. But he really has taken the boredom out of parallel bar work. That was such an interesting exercise.
Well, the Turk waits for his floor score. Little smile, not too disappointed. He sees it before we do. 9.012 for Samiloglu. 42.611, 11th position. Well, he really is on track for a massive personal best. Now let's get back to the chase for the medals. The Bulgarian lying in second position. This is Jordan Yovchev.
Straight Kachev. Full turn. Stoop through, finishing with full turn, but a little bit late, I think, to get scored an E element. Through from reverse grasp to Dislo in inverts, and then a double twisting double. Quiet man. Scoring 8.812, lacking the big start value, but certainly not losing a great deal on execution.
You can see there that Yovchev has one of his most favoured apparatus to finish with, so he'll look to come strong. Let's take a look at one of the Danish performers now. This is Rasmus Brantoft. And when Denmark hosted the European Championships back in 96, he took 17th position in the all-around.
Dane's got a good reputation on vault, though. Tall man. 1.5 twist from the Sukahara. All of these vaults named after the innovators. Sukahara, a great Japanese gymnast, whose son followed him into Olympic rankings. Unfortunately, they're just losing his legs. I think it was in a pucked position all the way through, but it wasn't a definitive enough shape.
Erik Revelish from Latvia next to go, leading after rotations 2 and 3, now down in fourth position. So again, with the two apparatus left to go, well, needs to regain or find that focus that really did have us on the edge of our seats for a while, because it would have been a real surprise, not taking anything away from Erik, but it would have been quite a surprise. The Latvian was storming ahead at one stage. Now back in fourth position, qualified in eighth. So again, the 22-year-old from Riga looking to go better than his personal best in his career to date in European Championship competition, where he was seventh in the Europeans in Paris back in 1998.
But remember, the Latvians have produced some good gymnasts over the years. when it was USSR, the great Valery Lyukin took the European title, and then Veros took the gold medal on floor in Sydney. So with that Voronin hop on high bar, this elegant man has still got a good future in the sport. World Championships this year, next year, and Olympic Games in the year 2004, who knows? The Latvians could live again. Nice skill from the 2 feet through into the full turn. His in-bar work very complicated. Twisting, using different hand positions. And a popular dismount, be it difficult. The back away or the fly away, that's leaving go of the bar whilst swinging round in a back giant circle. An accurate release into two straight somersaults with two twists. Here the full twisting one arm, and there the stoop through. Coming out from the stoop and then going straight into the heely, which is a full turn in reverse grasp. That's where the fingers are forwards. Moving on then to the top change, so the fingers are backwards and he's ready to swing down backwards, accelerating the giant and lifting. It was a massive dismount. Pity he couldn't anchor the landing.
So after five apparatus going into the sixth and final round, Patron now taking the lead for the first time. Bondarenko goes down to second, Yovchev up to third. Early leader Revelinch from Latvia now four, Podgorny five, Zazulia six, the local hero Maras in seventh, and Kwiatkowski of Germany is in eighth position. Victor Cano, the best of the Spanish, and Campos for Portugal, 10th. And Kurukai Jackson now down to 14th position, but still a respectable performance from the British number one. Well, the Romanians are on track for their second gold medal at these men's European Artistic Championships. And of course, the big guns will go on the high bar to bring this competition to a close. And the full story of the last round coming up after this short break. Stay with us. Sixth and final apparatus for all of the top 24 competitors in this competition two all-around event. We're at the European Championships for Men's Artistic Gymnastics. Kwiatkowski now for Germany. He's had a pretty good competition, looking to try and stay in the top 10. And of course, Kwiatkowski finishing with floor.
Oh dear, he got a total dead legs. He hit the floor and was in the wrong position to get a dynamic jump and sat down, unfortunately. And he'll be hard pushed to hold on to his sixth place with a fall. And once again, his flexibility costing him. I mentioned that on parallel bars, and that really brought him to grief on that skill on floor, where he needs to get a wide straddle to clear the flares on floor. Just an ordinary straight Arabian somersault into the corner. And the leg springs down. Those tight hamstrings costing him. But a clean exit with a double twisting back somersault.
Clear disappointment there for the German number one. He's been in the top eight through pretty much the whole part of the competition, but well, the judge has really given no choice. The first tumble turning into a nightmare.
And there's the dead legs. You saw that he just didn't time his jump from the floor. He arrived with his hips behind his takeoff point and could do nothing with it. Now a whip back into one and a half twisting back and one and a half twisting back again. And this is where his flexibility lets him down. Really is struggling. He's going to hit the floor at any time. His feet are getting lower and lower. Not wide enough. And see that bent left leg as he comes through. And of course, the lack of flexibility at the back of the leg means the quadricep can't lift the leg up off the floor. And I'm sure his coach will say, well, go back and do a bit more stretching, go.
Let's take a look at Kwiatkowski's score should come up any moment. You can see that very disappointing after really being in the chase in the early part of the competition. A low eight, possibly even less now. Another man that needs to finish on a high note. This is the last performance for the Ukrainian Roman Zazulia. Fourth in the Europeans 2 years ago. Coming into this final round in sixth position.
Release and catch coming, yes. Kovac straight. And Kovac ducked. They look very startling, but without twist, they're not particularly high scoring. It's the inbow. Oh, and he struggled there. Lost some direction on the twist. And he really is struggling to get this, keep this going. And what a magnificent job he did to get through that exercise, because he got some side arch on one of his twisting skills on the top of the bar from the overhead view. We might see that. Here the straight Kovac, in effect a double somersault backwards straight. And then he picks up the same in a tucked position.
Yordan Yovchev, world floor champion, and he'll need all of those skills and confidence now, as Yovchev, the Bulgarian, is in third position behind Bondarenko of Russia and Potra of Romania, who go on the high bar for their last piece.
And he looks as though he means business. Oh, lovely skill. 1 3/4 twisting Arabian dive roll. An E element, one of the most difficult. Now this is how this should be done. Just look at that flexibility. Clear from the floor, lots of speed. And then the strength. Fabulous. Russian lever. And he really does show the judges his variety of skill, his virtuosity. He tumbles forwards, he tumbles backwards, he twists, he's flexible, he's strong. And what can he deliver at the end? Ah, smashing. Double layout. Great stuff. And he'll be very happy with that, and so you, Nick, because he's just one of your favourites.
He is. I've been following Yordan Yovchev, and I agreed with your comments earlier that it's surely he's got to end his career by taking a major title, a bronze in the Olympics, a bronze in the World Championships last year, and he's holding on to bronze medal again in the Europeans, but this is just a delight. Everything that you expect to see on the floor, and the strength is just massive, combined with just brilliant flexibility. Such a pleasure to watch.
Well, he's just got to get back and work on the pommels and high bar. They're great stuff. That's the 1 1/2 twisting Arabian dive roll. Arabian 1 3/4 somersaults and 1 1/2 twists. And here's that lovely double layer. A little bit of a back arm circle to pull his shoulders up. Up to all the tricks of the trade.
Let's see how Zazulia fares. Well, he goes into second position. Now he's got to watch Bondarenko, Podgorny and Potra from Russia and Romania. Yovchev, and he's gone into first position. So he's ahead of Zazulia. 9.7 for the floor exercise, a brilliant finish. But as Monica has pointed out, a couple of bogey performances or poor scores there, particularly in the pommels and the high bar. Now, Russia's Bondarenko next to go. High bar routine, the 24-year-old born in Kazakhstan, a European champion, remember, back in 1998. As our expert here in the box has pointed out, possibly the most stylish of all the gymnasts out there, comes into this final performance of the day, lying in second position, locked in a classic battle with Dan Potra of Romania.
Yes, I think it's safe to say, in my opinion, he is the most complete gymnast in this championship. Kovac tucked, Kachev straight, and then in straddle. But of course, now only C and D elements. Needs in-bar skills, the endo into the full turn. Oh, and that went into orbit. That was a fantastic dismount. Absolutely fabulous and a startling routine. Absolutely startling. Crowd thrilling, but I don't think judge thrilling because he's just missing out some in-bar twisting. But really beautiful to watch. Closer look at his release and catches, I think. There's the tidy tucked Kovac, that's double tucked somersault. And he's going straight into the Katchev, innovated by former European champion Katchev. That was a straight one and that was a straddled one. And we see the women perform that particular skill on the asymmetric bars now. But I do hope we get a slow motion of his dismount. Here the full twisting one arm, introduced first of all by Suarez, the great Cuban, back in 1981 World Championships. Seems years ago, but just watch this dismount. Watch his feet, watch where they go. Up, hit the Union Jack, double twisting double, and brilliant landing. Well, he's certainly given it everything for gold.
He really has thrown the gauntlet down.
Absolutely.
His last performance, some will say an advantage going before Dan Petrat, who really will have to absorb a lot of pressure now. Surely that's good enough to put Bondarenko into top position. The judges understandably taking a little longer, and no, it is not. Bondarenko has gone into second position. Not enough score, 9.350. The Bulgarians in the crowd there have just picked up the fact that it means Jordan Yorvchev still leads and is heading for a potential European all-around gold. Of course, Petrat of Romania still to go on the high bar, and that really is quite a surprise. Expecting a bigger score, particularly the Russian elements of the crowd. This is Bazugo from Portugal, next to go. But, well, that really has given Petrat an opportunity. Needs a 9.325 or more to wrap up the title. Leonid Arkayev, just to the left of your screens there, not looking too happy at all.
No, we haven't seen much of him, have we? He's been hiding behind the scenes. But I think he's under no illusion that he was never meant to get in the big medals. Oh, dear, and that was a dangerous landing. The whole idea of men's artistic gymnastics is to produce skills within the ability of the gymnast, and I think that I can stick my neck out and say that that was beyond the ability of the gymnast, landing like that, wrenching his lower back, and he could pop his knees, really lacking in propulsion from the top of the apparatus.
Go back to the high bar. Now, Podgorny, again with Russia's last chance of taking the European all-around title. Coach Arkayev just behind, helping him up to the bar, of course. And he needs a big score here as Podgorny has dropped down into fifth position. Will it be Bulgaria? Will it be Romania? Or will it be Russia, still searching for their first gold at these Europeans?
But remember, Podgorny sat down on vault, so it's he's got a big hill to climb. And I don't think he can get 10.5 out of 10. But he certainly can get into the medals. Katchev piked. Oh, nice high stuff. Katchev straddled Ginger. Backseat circle. Steinemann giant into Stalder. Really showing good shoulder flexibility. Double twisting double. A bit short on the in-bar twisting, but certainly showing plenty of variety in the circle elements. In all the men's apparatus, they've got five groups of elements, and the gymnast must demonstrate at least a B element from every one of the five groups, and there's a whole mark laid aside for that, so five special requirements, each of 2/10.
Let's take a look at Vlasios Maras of Greece, his final performance of the day, the pommel horse. The junior stepping up the senior ranks last season and starting to make a very impressive mark. Now, Maras lying in seventh position.
Just letting the legs go on those double leg circles. Looking well on one pommel, good spindle. Oh dear. And he just lost momentum. I think if we see it in slow motion, he went for the pommel and hit the horse, or he went for the horse and hit the handle. But he really was a mishit with the hand there. He really came in to go behind the pommel and didn't quite judge his hand placing well enough, which is a shame because he's no mean pommel work. He's qualified for the individual apparatus finals on pommel horse. So he has got the potential to score quite highly, but this will knock him from an opportunity of getting in or near the medals. Half turn in the shears. The tricky part of the exercise for all of the gymnasts. A wee bit of a struggle up into the dismount. 1.5 pirouette. But his execution, it's so beautiful.
Well, the end of any hopes of a Greek medal as the host nation to these 25th European Championships. But still, they'll turn to this young man in the individual apparatus finals, the hot favourite to take the gold in the men's high bar, but troubles here in the pommel horse. And Monica, this has proved to be the bogey apparatus for many of the competitors here today.
Oh, it's the hardest piece of apparatus, like the beam is to women. It's very, very hard. Once you have got one little part of the skill and the inertia going wrongly, it's very, very difficult to regenerate speed and keep that pendulum action of the legs going.
Podgorny goes into third position, but of course we're waiting for one more performer on the men's high bar. That's Dan Petra leading, coming into sixth and final rotation, 55.361. Well, a little bit of congratulations there. Sixth position, 54.399. Just to remind you, just 19 years of age, this young man from Athens. Great future ahead. And Greece really does have a star in the making. We've got a World Championships coming up in November this year, another Worlds the year after, and of course, Greece will then hold the 2004 Summer Olympic Games. Now, Romania's chance to make it two golds out of two competitions in these European Championships. Dan Petra, 9.325 or more. The Romanian needs to claim the all-around champion and to become the first ever Romanian since 1955, when this competition was created, to do so.
And what huge pressure. He looks so secure. A lot of in-bar work. Stalder, full turn to reverse. Ginger, oof, that was a bit close. And for my money, everybody looks absolutely delighted, and the camp looks as though he's limping a little bit. The camp seems to think that he's done enough, but for my money, it certainly lacked the excitement in comparison to Bondarenko's. But it's not all about excitement, it's about technical expertise, and there are 8 men there to judge that.
I think you've also summed it up, Monica, now with the change in the code since the last Olympic Games of Sydney. The in-bar work now taking on much greater importance in the way the scores are awarded. Just to remind you, it's a 9.325 or more for Dan Petra. The top qualifier, the favourite, got off to a disastrous start with an 8.787 in the floor. Well, the congratulations in the Romanian camp. They've obviously seen the scores before we do. There it is, 55.710. Romania, for the first time in the history of its men's gymnastics, has taken the European all-around gold. Yuranovchev of Bulgaria confirmed with the bronze. Bondarenko has to settle. I beg your pardon. Yovchev takes the silver for Bulgaria. Bondarenko settling for bronze. Podgorny also taking fourth position. Early leader Revelinch from Latvia finishing 5. Zazulia 6. What a great result for Maras in 7th position. And the British number one, Kanukai Jackson, finishing down in 15th spot, 51.843. Well, I'm sure that the young British number one will not be too disappointed. But it is Romania who continues to dominate at these European Championships, their second gold medal. And of course, they continue to rewrite the record books over in Romania, their first team gold yesterday. And now their first all-around gold competition for Dan Potrat. 55.710 to take the European title for 2002. Welcome back to Petras in the men's individual.